Management. And today I'm going to talk about external tools in Canvas. Since we started using Canvas, we've been experimenting with a lot of external tools. And external tools are the tools that are available through Canvas. So it could be any other tool or developed by our developers at the school that we access them through Canvas. So most of these integrations are available through the course navigation, and I'm going to show some examples. Some of the integrations that when you access to them, they are on the left navigation bar, so you can access through that. Some of them are available through assignments, so if you're using a specific tool, external tool, you can only access them through assignments. And some of the examples are here, like MobLab and CritiqueIt. Some of them are available through modules, so in order to use those tools, you have to use modules. And also HTML editor that we are using right now, WarpWire, and I'm going to show that. And we also experimented by integrating these tools within the sub-account and within courses. So we tried different levels of integrations also. So past and current. So far, we use WarpWire. We name it, it shows on the left navigation bar, and we name it course videos. WarpWire is our media platform. So instead of Panopto, School of Management is using WarpWire, and this is how we are accessing WarpWire from within Canvas. So basically, I'm just gonna you can see it here. It's on the left navigation, and when students or users, instructors, when they click on it, they are accessing WarpWire within Canvas, and it's already integrated. They don't have to go to another platform to use the platform. They just within Canvas access to this platform. So gonna go to the next one. SOM Syllabus, that's another tool that we developed at School of Management to have access to our syllabi on a different platform. So I'm going to show an example too. And hopefully we will be retiring that tool soon, because we're going to go back to the syllabus available within Canvas. So if a user clicks on the SOM syllabus, they have access to the syllabus that is actually hosted in another platform called Confluence. So again, without leaving Canvas, by clicking on that link, they access to it, and they don't have to sign in, they don't have to enter any username or password. Roster tool was developed by SOM developers also. We since then retired it, because now university has a really good photo roster that we can use. But before, university had a roster, we created our own with the pictures and with the name of the students and their emails. We are not using it anymore, but that's another tool that we developed and we've been using with Canvas. And VoiceThread, again, while integrating Canvas, we integrated a lot of tools, and one of the tools that we tried out was VoiceThread. And VoiceThread is an online platform for providing feedback on the media files. And the feedback can be an audio file, video file, text, and any type of file that you can share. So I'm going to click on it so you see how we accessed it, but since then we stopped paying for the VoiceThread license, so we don't have any access to it. But again, VoiceThread was available on the left navigation bar, as well as in assignments. So we could create assignments and have students access VoiceThread, or we were using it on the left navigation bar, so our users would just click on it and go to VoiceThread without entering their username and password. So these are the ones that we've been using, and these are tested. So when I say tested, I mean we hear about these tools and we read about them and we investigate and we implement it in our sometimes account level, sometimes at the sandbox at course level. I try to do it mostly at the course level. These are some of the ones that we tested, and we decided that it's not ready yet. It's not working as much as we want them to be working. There are some issues with them, so we are still either trying to decide or decided to not to pursue. So one of them is called TurnItIn. You're all familiar with TurnItIn. It's a plagiarism tool. And we are using it externally. So our faculty and staff members are going to TurnItIn and uploading all these documents. So we were thinking it would be helpful if we provide this access within Canvas. Unfortunately, there, right now you see error because my test account is expired. We had some issues with it. It wasn't 100% accurate. It works better externally as another platform rather than within Canvas. So we are still trying to decide if we should just ask our users to use an external platform or use within Canvas. The next one that we are testing is, actually we did already, we are not pursuing it because library just made a presentation, so we are one of the schools using ARIS system heavily. So if we were to use Harvard Business Publishing LTI, that would mean our students would go to course files and then for course reserves and then Harvard cases. So they would have to go to three different places to get one course material. So we decided that unless it integrates with course resources or files, we are not going to use Harvard cases. So we decided not to. I don't have any access to it right now. StudyNet, just another one. I don't know if you're familiar with StudyNet. StudyNet allows faculty members, instructors to create their course packs. It could be a website, it could be a file that they own creation, or it could be a case that is developed and, you know, presented by any other business school. So we also tested it, and we decided that we are not going to go with it because just like with Harvard Business Cases, this required our students and faculty to go to yet another place. Here, right now, currently, they only go to files and course reserves, which is down there. But if we were to use StudyNet, then they would also have to go to StudyNet to get some of the files. So we are looking for a solution that will allow us to put all the resources in one place. So our students and faculty, they don't have to go to three, four different places. We haven't found it yet, but we are looking and continue to look. So currently being tested, so our last two tools that currently being tested and piloted, one of them is CritiqueIt. It was introduced by CTL. So after investigating it, I introduced to one of our faculty members. He has used it for his spring class. And he actually, for CritiqueIt, as I mentioned before, some tools are available within assignments. So CritiqueIt available only through assignments. So if you decide to use a tool that allows faculty instructors to use this tool, so we have to use CritiqueIt through assignments. So when they create an assignment and they select external tool, and students, if and need to do, use it, they go through the assignments. And CritiqueIt is online critiquing tool that allows instructors to, or users I should say, because students can also upload files. They can upload their images or their videos, and people can, or even like Word files, and people can give comments on them. They can record videos and they can provide comments on them. I'm going really fast, but you know, you can ask me more because we have like a couple of minutes left. So currently, we are also testing Variscite. I mentioned our issues with TurnItIn. So we are investigating another online plagiarism tool called Variscite and trying to see if it works better within Canvas. So we are currently testing it. So we've been doing some tests, and if we decide, okay, this is better, then I'm going to ask a faculty member to pilot it next fall, and then we will be able to decide after the pilot if we're going to go with the tool or not. So again, it's via assignments. I select external tool, select Variscite. So students, when they're uploading their files, you know, assignment files, they go within Canvas, but they're actually uploading in Variscite, and faculty can access also from Canvas. finally coming soon. So this is the tool that we tested and we piloted. We didn't pilot within Canvas, but we piloted outside and we decided to, you know, go with it. It's called MobLab. It's an online gaming for economics and business cases. So we are going to start using it next fall. And just like I mentioned before, MobLab is available through assignments or modules. So a person who you presented about modules, so we can put MobLab games and activities under each module. It allows us to do that. So as you can see, first we activate it. So that's one thing. Some of the internal external tools require activation. So we require students to click there first to activate their account. And then they access through SOM account, and now their account is activated in MobLab, they can start using it. So we can start weekly modules and add MobLab games for them to access it. And thank you. Any questions? Yes.
So are these platforms that you've developed, or do you use?
Some of them, like the Syllabus that we developed and Roster we developed, but MobLab, Variscite, TurnItIn, it's developed by the companies.
So I need to have a sign-up tool for my students for labs, and the scheduler in Canvas doesn't work for what I need to do. Mm-hmm. So I'm learning how to do it in a platform, a database platform called Airtable. Mm-hmm. And it has an API, but you know the students don't have access to I don't have access to the roster and their schedule and so forth, so they have to get an account on a separate platform and so forth. So it'd be great if I could get the roster information and so forth, or put the Airtable tool into the Canvas API. So can I do that?
You need to contact Pilar and her team, I think. You know, we worked with them to create our own tools for SOM. But you have to check with them. So all the databases that we use for the roster came from SOM databases.
Yeah, so it sounds like it worked for you then.
It worked, yes. And there's also some Canvas groups that they do, they do share their resources and developments on GitHub. So you may find something like that already developed and you just modify it to your own purposes.
Okay. Well, so the roster was tricky because our developers were pulling information that always wasn't accurate to Banner. So in the people tool, and then I know that the roster tool that we use now, it was calling different students. So it's tricky, but I think it's all sorted out. Yeah.
Okay.
One other comment is there's a website, EduApp Center, that lists over 200 externally developed tools for various things that are already plug and play for Canvas. Mm-hmm. That's not to say that you can just immediately plug it in. We have some protocols for actually checking to make sure that any data shared with an external vendor is secure because of FERPA and that sort of thing. But you might very well find an application that does what you're looking for on the EduApp Center, and then you can contact the Canvas group and say, hey, I would really like to look into plugging this into my site.
Any questions? Okay, thank you.